Best Real Madrid midfielder for each and every year, 2014 to 2024. Let's go. So with 2014, we're starting off with one of the best Real Madrid midfielders, I would argue the best, Luka Modric. He was flop of the season in 2013. 2014, he made one of the biggest career comebacks I've ever seen. At the grand age of 28, 28 is when players start to fall off. Now, this guy started his career in the time when he was 28. That's crazy. He was also responsible for Sergio Ramos' beautiful header in the 94th minute against Atletico. What a good midfielder he was. And for 2014, he was miles above the rest. 2015, we brought in Toni Kroos and James Rodriguez as two new midfielders. And listen, this might take you by surprise. James Rodriguez was our best midfielder. This man would score banger after banger after banger. 100 million back then was crazy to spend. James was worth it. Seriously worth it. Now sure, the next seasons followed up, he wasn't too good. Coming off of that fantastic World Cup, joining Real Madrid, and then being one of our best players, I think he was definitely the second best player behind Ronaldo for 2015. 2016, this one is an interesting one, and I have chosen Casemiro. Why I chose Casemiro? Because this man broke out, truly his breakout season. Our breakout star, this guy, came out of nowhere. Our best CDM that I think we've had in our entire history. Zidane put him in that position and took James Rodriguez out of the squad to put Casemiro in the squad. And it led to us winning the Champions League. 2017, now listen, you're going to call me corny for this, but I'm saying KCM, the entire trio in the midfield. Kroos was on a whole different level. Modric was on a whole different level. Casemiro, I mean, no words can describe them. They were just, all three of them were the best midfielders of 2017. We won the Champions League for the 12th time that season. They were unplayable. 2018, this one belongs to the Ballon d'Or winner of 2018, Luka Modric. Now, I'm not including his Croatia ex. I'm not including how good he was in the World Cup. I am just talking about how good this guy was for us in 2018, the entire season. And he was just a magician. And I'm putting him there for 2018 because he was the best midfielder in the world, period. 2019 was a more so frustrating year for Real Madrid. Modric was just so poor that season, getting owned by Frenkie de Jong. Are you crazy? Kroos was having so many off games, it's insane. And to me, a midfielder that stood out and played his part, played it better than every midfielder in the team, it was Casemiro. I mean, this guy was scoring bangers, overhead kicks. Casemiro was amazing. Even though we went trophyless, we were just nothing without him. He was our only good CDM. He was our best midfielder for 2019. 2020. Now, I could put the entire KCM here, I could put Valverde here, but I've chosen one in particular, Toni Kroos. 2020 was just this year. I mean, bro, let's go back into the El Clasico. He told Vinny where to go. He passed directly to Vinny. Vinny scored in the El Clasico. Kroos was just on a different level. Valverde was good enough to be put there. We won La Liga that season. Kroos, I'm putting him for 2020. 2021, this was a droughtful season. And let's be honest, everybody was injured. Modric was injured. Kroos, Isco, bro. Our entire team was injured. But to me, who was the best midfielder for 2021 was the guy who would play right wing. He would play right back. He would play central midfield. He would play CDM. It's Valverde. Fede Valverde truly showed to everyone his value, how important he was. This guy was so versatile. Now, so I could put Kroos there again. I could put Modric there. I could put Casemiro there. Valverde, I'm putting him here. More so, it's biased. My opinion is biased, sure. But Valverde, to me, surprised me. He was so good. And from there, his career truly took off. He was so important for us in 2021. Under Zinedine Zidane. Now sure, we went trophyless, but Valverde was amazing. 2022, a Champions League winning season, Modric was our best midfielder. His performances against PSG, his amazing traveller pass against Chelsea. Modric was truly the MVP. Modric, our most important midfielder, most important player, I would argue. He was just on a whole different level. Like, truly. 2023, this is a truly a difficult one. But I've gone for Valverde. Now, listen, Valverde, I know, he was barely used at midfield. He was used mostly at the right wing. Blonde hair Valverde was just incredible. This guy would run back to defend. This man would score a banger. This guy would cross the ball. This guy would just pretty much do everything. Truly, one of the most underrated and one of the most hardworking players you will see in football today. And I don't think you get a player like Valverde in today's day and age. He's a dying breed in football today. But I'm putting him there for best midfielder of 2023. 2024, now listen. I know what you're going to say. You're going to call me a fool because I said best player for each season. But I mean, we had four. It's Cruz. It's Tchouaméni. It's Valverde. And it's Jude Bellingham. Let me give you a reason for each of them. Cruz was at the top of his game this season. He retired at the top of his game, assisting in the big moments. Truly a big game player, stepped up for us when it mattered most. Tchouaméni, we have not lost a game in which Tchouaméni has started. That should tell you enough. This guy's put in a lot of work this season. Valverde, I'm going to say for the exact same reasons that I did in 2023. Jude Bellingham, for obvious reasons, because of him scoring 30 goals and assists in his debut season as well. Now, sure, he's not a pure midfielder in my opinion. I can't put him in the same category as a Modric. I'm going to put him there because he is a midfielder, attacking midfielder. So I'm putting all four of them as best midfielders for 2024. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to smash like, subscribe, turn on notifications, and peace out.